Creating a signature stamp brush is easier than you think, and I'm going to show you exactly how you can do it, no matter your skill level. So step number one is pretty simple. We're just going to start by creating a square canvas. The exact dimensions don't matter. As long as it is square, you're totally okay. Now step two is going to be figuring out what you want to use as your signature. So you can either draw your signature with a brush, or you could add text going in the wrench icon menu here and selecting add text from the add submenu. Now one thing that is important is that no matter if you decide to draw your signature or to type it out, make sure that your color is set to black. So step three is going to be creating any effect that you want to use for your signature. Now here I'm going to go with an embossing effect, but I'm going to link in the description below a few videos that you can use for different kinds of effects. So open up your layer panel and duplicate your signature layer by swapping it towards the left with one finger and then tapping on duplicate. You're then going to select a light gray and use that to recolor the top copy of your signature. Then with the arrow tool selected, go ahead and move that layer towards the bottom right, and you're going to see it's going to start looking a little bit more like a shadow. But right now it looks like the signature is duplicated, which is not what we want. We want it to be kind of a shadow. So we're going to apply the top layer as a clipping mask. So just tapping on it and selecting clipping mask. And the last thing we have to do to create our embossing effect is adding a bit of a blur, because right now it's really super harsh. So still with the top layer selected, go in the adjustment panel, select Gaussian blur, and add as much or as little blur as you want. So once you're happy with the effect, go back in the wrench icon menu, and in the add submenu, select copy canvas. Then open up your brush panel, and in whichever brush pack you want, just tap on the plus icon right here, which is going to create a brush from scratch. And here we're not going to go through all the settings, but we have a few that we need to absolutely change. Main one being in the stroke path, increasing the spacing to maximum so that you can get a stamp effect. Now to add your signature shape, we're going to go in the shape section here. We're going to tap on edit, import, and then we're going to simply paste what we copied. Now one thing that is really important here is to make sure that your background behind the signature is dark. So if, like me, it is light, just tap on the brush with two fingers to invert the colors. Then you can simply tap done. And if you're working with an Apple Pencil, you might want to disable anything that might be related to pressure sensitivity. So we're going to lower the opacity to none so that the opacity of our brush remains the same no matter what we do. Last little thing we might want to do is going in this property menu and activating the Use Stamp Preview toggle, which is not going to change anything in the actual behavior of the brush, but it's just going to make it easier for you to see the brush in the brush library. You can also play with the maximum size of the brush. Here, the exact number doesn't really matter much. Again, it's going to depend on multiple factors like the canvas size that you started with. But for a stamp brush like this, it's really not the end of the world. So just set it to probably 300, 400, somewhere around that, and that's going to be totally fine. And now if we tap done, you're going to see your brush in the brush list. Now, if we want to test it real quick, we can go ahead and hide the layers that we just created, tap to create a new one, pick any color that we would like to use for a signature, and then simply tap on the canvas to add your signature. And just a quick note here, if you are working in a piece that has a color in the background or multiple colors in the background, you might want to set your signature layer to either multiply or linear burn to get the best of the embossing effect. And you can also play with the opacity of that layer, of course, to adjust the contrast. If you enjoyed this tutorial and want to learn more Procreate hacks, I highly recommend you check out this playlist because I have a bunch more videos for you. But before you leave, make sure to give this video a like and subscribe to the channel so you don't miss any of the weekly videos I post every Tuesday and Saturday. Then click on the link right here and I'll meet you there.